Hello, and welcome back to The Long Dark, episode 30. When I left off, we had just found this wonderful little community here. We had raided the gas station here in the coastal highway. But I've made the decision that I need to go back. So my plan is to drop off a lot of this stuff at the house that we first put some stuff down in when we came into the zone, and then to depart and to head back towards. Okay, we've got laceration, blood loss. I'm gonna need some first aid quick. Oh, the condition is dropping. So, okay, blood loss from a wolf bite. We're gonna use this bandage and hopefully get rid of that infection as well. That infection risk. Okay. Oh man. I don't know where he came from. Goodness. Goodness, goodness. Well, that's quite a way to start an episode. Oh, man. Okay. That got my heart pounding. Let's get out of here. Whew, man. It's kind of nice having the lichen-covered bandages. It takes care of the infection risk and stops the bleeding all at the same time. Oh, man. Oh, I bet it was a wolf from one of these groups out here on the ice. Look at that. It's like an island out there. There's like a couple islands out there. Man, we're gonna have to check this place out, but we're gonna need a gun. We're gonna need a gun, and we're gonna need all my birch saplings so I can make some arrows. So we're gonna go back. We're gonna get the gun. We're gonna get the stuff we need to make arrows. Grab our bear hide, our deer hide. Probably a lot of our whetstones and sewing kits. And I'm just going to drop off, I'm going to leave a lot of stuff here, and we're going to go back nice and light so we can bring as much with us as we can. I'm not going to grab everything. Trunk is locked. Oh, I could be searching these vehicles. Man, I should have thought about that. No, we're going to leave the newsprint. Oh, snap. Yes! Improves rifle firearm skill! Yes! Oh, that is so wonderful. Radio, nothing. Glove box. Wow. I could be searching all these vehicles. So it won't let me look in the back seat, though. Let's see if I can... Yeah, here we go. Into the back seat. A hat, some cloth. I'll take the cloth. I'm going to have to come back and search all these vehicles. There's so much here to search. We could probably live here on the coastal highway for quite some time. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to spend some time at Mystery Lake. Scrapping some of the stuff that we're not going to need for parts. Please stay away from me, Mr. Wolf. I'm not gonna deal with this again. If I hear a wolf coming, I should have been quicker on the draw. I could have pulled the torch out. No, I need to stay away. I need to stay away. I don't want to get attacked twice. My condition was doing pretty good, and that wolf took me down quickly. I'm gonna spend a little bit of time recovering. I just want to stay away. Yet another reason I need my rifle. If I can get some more wolf pelts going, I can make a, you know, wolf skin jacket. Not that we've had many days where we needed to be warmer than we already are. Our current clothing setup has kept us pretty warm the majority of the time, but it'll just be that much better. We still have days that are really cold, and it would be nice to not... Oh, look at that! I know, I get distracted easily. It's, you know, it is what it is. But there's a building up on that island. See, I didn't see any of this when the fog was rolled in. There's a big mountain over there. Yeah. So we might have to, we might have to stay the night here. 3 hours of daylight left? Maybe. We'll see. I'm for sure going to drop a lot of this stuff off in the one house. From there, I'm not really sure. We'll have to do a little bit of inventory management. Probably stay the night. And then just make a beeline back. Not mess around, not explore, go back, get the stuff, and come back as quickly as possible. That's my plan. I'm going to keep the stuff with me to make arrows, and I have my book now. Thought I heard a wolf. I've made some extra torches now, so I'm not afraid to use them at all. Okay, as I was saying, I'll have stuff to make arrows. Oh, but they take a workbench. That's fine. I'll have a book that I can read if I get trapped in, due to weather or something like that. The question is, should I stay the night here with 2 hours of daylight left? Or should I try to get back up to the top of the area, which I think is going to be what I try to do. So let's put 2 liters of water in there. That'll help. We'll put one axe, one book, the pry bar, the tools, and then a lot of this food. All right, so let's see. All kinds of peaches, peanut butter. Look at all this soda. Goodness. Herbal tea. Now we're going to keep one of those. Oh, these don't weigh a lot, but it adds up. Let's store you and you. We'll store all the stuff that has really good quality. And we'll keep the stuff that needs to be eaten. Nope. Well, maybe not. Because I need to get rid of as much as possible. Yeah, probably get rid of these peaches. We'll stash some of these MREs. Peaches, peanut butter. Alright, let's see. Tools. What tools can we part with? Put some of these torches in here. The flares, the lantern fuel, matches. We'll keep the rifle ammunition. Yeah, here. We'll store these sewing kits. 2 whetstones. This fishing tackle doesn't take up hardly. Oh, see, I could... No, I need to... I'm hoarding too much stuff. I really am. We're going to keep that book. We're going to keep the cloth. We're going to store the scrap metal. Yep, we're going to store the rose hips. I'm going to put some of these guts on the ground here so they can start curing. Let's see. We're getting there. 2 hours of daylight left. We're getting there. This is all the heaviest stuff. Let's leave the storm lantern. And we'll leave the antiseptic because I have the bandages that help with infection. Leave the lantern fuel, an extra can opener, all this stuff. We're down to 27 kilograms. I think we can store the hacksaw. I think that's going to be it. We're so tired, though. 2 hours of daylight remaining. Oh, let's, I think I'm going to make the trek back with what we have. We shouldn't be too slow. We're barely over our weight. If we were fully rested, we would be under our weight. But I know that there is... Yeah, there we go. Look how fast we're moving. I know that there is a, there's a building up at the top there, and that's where I want to go. So we're just going to follow the road back up and get back to where we were. We can run a little bit. No, I don't want to run. We're going to get really tired soon. but I want to make as much progress as possible. I don't want to wait here any longer than I have to. So our weight's down. We'll stay the night somewhere, hopefully at the building, but if we have to set up a little area to sleep in our sleeping bag, we will. It's plenty warm enough with our gear on. Our deer clothing. Yeah, look at that out there. It's like that island out there, and are just power lines going out there, it looks like, or trees, maybe? Man, I don't even know. So much stuff to check out here. I don't know if this area is larger than Mystery Lake, but it seems more open, for sure. Way more open. 1 hour of daylight left. I'm not really concerned about it yet. I'm more worried about our energy reducing our speed. Because if we start crawling from fatigue, we're going to be done. We're going to have to hole up for the night. Looks like it went down a degree, so it's getting colder. Which, I mean, is kind of obvious. The sun's going down. It's going to get colder. But we get to check out this beautiful sunset twilight scenario. Okay, so this is where the road split. There's a lower path and an upper path, and I'm going to take the upper path. I'm not sure which is shorter. But I know that if I walk down into that low area, it's going to be a steeper hill to climb. What do we have here? Oh, it's a rock. Yep. Lots of firewood out here. I have enough firewood. I could start a fire for a little bit. Oof, we are really tired now. Feeling really drained. But we should get back relatively quick. What is that? Is that something moving up there? No, okay. Just my eyes playing tricks on me. I'll take that. I'll settle for that. Wish I had a compass. I'm pretty sure this is heading west, because the sunset looked like it was in this direction. But a compass would be really nice. Oh, look at this! There's another little building here that I didn't even see, because when I came down the road, it would be behind me, kind of tucked away. Man, how did I miss this place? Well, I don't necessarily want to load up my inventory, but this is as good a place as any to stop, and we'll see what's in it in the last hour of daylight, do a little rummaging, and then probably rest here for the night. Get out first thing in the morning. Got another lantern. Cloth, yeah, we'll take that. Metal container, come on. That'll come in handy. Antibiotics, yeah, sure. A ragged down jacket. Minimal wind blocking capability. Yeah. Not good. Not good at all. Alright, let's get the I put the storm lantern. Okay. Well, we're gonna start you up so that I can see what I'm working with over here. Look at that. Aha, see? A tin of coffee. Valuable stuff. Grape soda, yep. Plastic container has nothing for me. Nothing at all. Make sure I check for books strewn about. Yep, flare. Mm-hmm. Okay. So we will extinguish you and store you right there. Okay. Less than 1 hour of daylight left. Well, before we take a nap, or before we sleep for the night, we're going to drink a bunch of water. Oh, I have not cooked this venison yet. Well, that's fine, that's fine. We'll eat this fish. Yeah, that'll work. That'll work for now. Let's try to get fully rested. We'll sleep for a good 11 hours. Let our condition improve. Ooh, looks like we had a storm or fog in the middle of the night, maybe. What do we have? Less than 1 hour of darkness left. Beautiful. So we're going to drink some of this soda, take care of our hydration, and get a few extra calories. There you go. Oof. Three sodas first thing in the morning. Grape, and then Summit, and then orange soda. Mm. Oh, wait, no. What did I do? Oh, I tried to put my bedroll down. No, we don't need to do that. Okay, so we're pretty full. Let's depart. I think this is good enough. No, that's the storm lantern. Goodness, I can't see. Leave. Yes. It should be the beginning of morning nautical twilight, I believe. You know, if that is such a thing in the game, but pretty sure that the less than an hour of darkness remaining. Yep. Means, oof, what was that? Yeah, so we have a little bit of fog, so maybe it wasn't a storm that rolled in, but fog. But we're moving pretty good. We got our weight down. We're very well rested, slaked, full, warm. Temperature's a little cold, though. -2 is what it feels like, so we're going to lose warmth. We'll keep an eye on that. We'll see if the temperature is trending down. If it is, if it continues to lower... I wonder if that's a shortcut. See, I feel like I should give it a... Oof, no, I don't want to jump down that. It's a good way to hurt my bad ankle. I don't want to do that. But if there is a shortcut to get back without following this winding road, I'd like to take it. But I don't know this area well enough yet. That's all right. If we get cold and we have to start a fire... Here, I'm going to cut this corner, though. If we get cold and we have to start a fire, it'll give us a chance to cook the venison we have. And then once we get back to Mystery Lake, we have a bunch of fish that's already cooked. So we just have to get back and grab all our fish and our hide and our rifle. Oh, they're not going to let me up this way. See, and that's why I should have stayed on the road. Maybe here. Maybe here. Dang it. Oof, easy. It's a good way to hurt my ankle. So let's just stay with the road then. It's so steep I couldn't get up it in the snow. Snow's way too thick. Just navigating this road is atrocious. It must not be a paved road. We got grass. Although I guess it could have, over time, grown through the cracks in the road. At least I can follow it still. It's a good marker for where I need to go. Now, one of the things that I want to do on my way back to Mystery Lake, because I'm not in a huge rush. A lot of this, you know, there's no mission. We're playing the sandbox version of the game. So really, it's just survive as long as you can. And I learned from the first game that involves watching your condition. So we're back up to 100%, which is really great. But really, we just need to survive, so... We need to take our time, be efficient. I know that I don't want to stay in one area the whole time, but I don't want to constantly push forward into new territories just for the sake of seeing new stuff, that it creates a danger, you know, of pushing the envelope of where I'm comfortable and where my supplies are. Because I'm starting to realize... It is virtually impossible to take everything with you. You have to pick and choose what's the most important. And as far as I can tell, the rifle ammunition, bows and arrows, food, and tools to repair stuff, like sewing kits, whetstones, those are all the most important, as far as I can tell. So those are the things I want to prioritize bringing with me. Everything else you seem to find extras of. I've found so many hatchets and so many pry bars. It seems goofy to bring them with me from place to place. I mean, especially because the tools tend to weigh the most. Anyways, I got distracted. What I was getting at is one of the things I want to do is to go down to the bottom of this ravine. So I have a lot of energy. I'm well rested. I'm going to take the rope down to the bottom and see what's down there, because I'm not in a hurry. I know just from how slowly the fish in my inventory was going bad that it'll still be there. And I put the hide of the wolf and the bear in a container, so they should stay pretty good for a while. Let's go nice and easy. Nice and easy. I don't want to hear any creaking. Nope, nope. Easy, easy. Don't look down. Okay. Whew. That increased my heart rate a little bit. But now we're doing fine. We're on the other side. Goodness. I'm not sure what's going to be down at the bottom of the ravine, if there's perhaps a path to another zone. I have a feeling, though, it's not going to be the case. I'm not sure if... because I believe the path behind the dam is probably the other connection to the zone. So when I look back at the zones in the beginning of the map, it says that the Mystery Lake connects to the Coastal Highway and Pleasant Valley. So I imagine the path behind the dam would be the other direction. But I don't know. Maybe not. Until I know what lies at the bottom of the ravine, it's, you know, it's a big old mystery. So we'll go down there. We'll check it out. I have a feeling, though, it's not going to be anything other than just, like, some stuff down there. Maybe a killed deer. Maybe, I don't know, a cave, some boxes I can rummage through. I'm not sure, but we're going to find out. I imagine this will be my last trip to Mystery Lake for some time. I don't want to get in this back-and-forth habit. So I'm going to grab everything that's near and dear to me, even if it puts me a little bit over the weight limit, and we're going to say goodbye to Mystery Lake for a while. So if you're a fan of Mystery Lake, or you really like the camp office and all the little surrounding area that we've become so familiar with, soak it in, because when we get there, it'll be the last time we'll see it for probably some while. What do we have over this way? Well, that's right. I looked over here and decided this was not a way I wanted to go. Yeah, it just drops off. Nothing over there I want. And over there... what do we have? No, nothing. So the rope is somewhere over there, and it goes straight down. I'm intrigued. We have plenty of energy, though. Hopefully, it'll be enough energy to go down and come back up. But if not, if we have to make a fire... brew some coffee, cook the venison, take a little, you know, hour, 2 hour nap to get the energy to come back up, that's fine, then that's what we'll do. At this point, looks like it's warming up. We're back to feeling like a zero C. Did I check back in here? What's all this stuff here? Yeah, I did. I checked back in there. All right. Boy, this little area here was a little longer than I remembered. That's no worries. It's not going to be a problem. We're going to... yep, there's my rope. And that's where I'm going. I don't want to end up in a situation where I slip and fall, though. So if there is even a doubt in my mind... that we won't have the energy to climb back up, or even to get down safely, then we're gonna rest. We're gonna take a nap, brew some coffee, whatever we have to do. I'm not gonna chance it. Not at all. All right. So we go up on this train, and then we'll cross on the tree. Nice and easy. Don't look down. Don't slip in the snow. Okay. Whew. Oh, look at that. Another feather. I'll take that. All right. So now we'll come over here. I'm going to get some more of this lichen. That bandage actually worked out really well. It totally took away the need for antiseptic, which is really heavy, actually. So we'll get three. And we'll make another one of those bandages. And we'll just keep those bandages on us and leave the antiseptic in a house. All right, let's do this. Oh my, look at all that. Oh, what is that? Like sticks and stuff? Okay. All right, we're doing good. We're doing fine. Nice and easy. Going up is going to be the hard part. That's all right. You can do it. You can do it. Boom. All right, how much energy did that use? Not too much. We're winded. But it's not that bad. The ravine basin. We could cut down some firewood for a fire. I think we're going to have to do that to make some coffee. But that's not a big deal. But let's see what this is all about here. What is this? Newsprint. Advanced guns, guns, guns. Packed full of advice and technical details about how to be a better shooter? Oh, 25 hours of research, but improves the rifle firearm skill by 10 points. Well, now we've got plenty of reading material. Man. See, and it was right in this little cranny over here. You gotta check everything in these areas. Emergency kit? A distress pistol? Well, I don't... Okay. All right, that's fine. I'm not sure when that'll be useful, but I'm going to take it. I'm happy with just the firearms magazine, really. Everything else is a bonus. Okay, so let's look at this. Distress, emergency beacon into the air, lamp fires, flare shells. This gun is not currently loaded. Okay, so I got a flare gun, but no flares for it. That's fine. Let's keep following this little ravine area here and see what we get. I don't want to leave this area unexplored. At this point, anything I leave unexplored is just something I have to come back to at a later date. Ooh, mushrooms. Yeah, we'll take some of these. Yes, indeed. Okay. Looks like it keeps going a little bit. Ooh, bunnies! Okay, well, we don't have any snares. Oh, that's another thing I need to grab on my way back from Mystery Lake. Here we go. This is what I was hoping for. Wait a second. Wait a second. A cave with a deer carcass out front? What? This doesn't feel like a good place to be at all. Ooh, let's get some of these. Get some of these rose hips. And then let's harvest this deer quickly. So we'll use a hatchet for the meat. Now we have even more venison we can cook. And then, oh, do I want to go for the hide and the guts? Oh, no. No, just, well. No. We're going to leave the hide. I need to be specific about what I'm going to load up into my inventory. And I don't want to hang out here very long because, well, A, the weather is deteriorating. It's getting warmer, but visibility is coming down. B, any cave with an eaten animal in front of it screams to me not a place you want to hang out. That's just my two cents. So we're still winded. We have dry mouth. We're hungry. My plan is going to be to start a fire. We're going to cook the venison, make some coffee, get ourselves a little bit of extra energy, and then assess if we can climb the rope back up to the top. And then that's probably where we'll wrap things up once we get back up. Oh, I wonder if I can get up there. Wow, that's going to be a heck of a climb. Jeez. Okay. All right. It doesn't look like we can get up there at all. And this thing doesn't appear to be open. What do we have over here? No. Okay. All right. 10 hours of daylight. That's plenty. Let's go ahead and break this down. I know, we're getting tired. That's fine. All right, so we're not going to end the episode here as much as we are kind of getting close to the end. What is all this? How did I miss this? Nothing on him anyways. But I'm not going to end the episode without climbing back up. I want to at least make it back up. It would be sort of a cliffhanger. No pun intended, but I'm not going to do that, so we're going to go back up first. So let's make ourselves a fire. Yep, campfire right here. So we're not going to burn our books. Jeez. We'll burn that book, but not the good books. No. Nothing like that. Oh, you know what? I don't even think we're going to do this. Because if we fail a couple of times, it's no big deal. 80% chance of success is still pretty good. So that's what we'll do. Hopefully we didn't waste a match. I mean, I don't know. If I have the book, I probably should have just used the book. It weighs 0.5 kilogram. Oh, it is what it is. So we'll put one fir log on the fire. Yes. Thank you.
Pretty well.
Fuel, we'll put one piece of fir firewood. Then we're gonna cook all this venison up. We're gonna cook all the venison first. And then we're going to heat up some coffee, and we're gonna drink that before anything. Because there's no point drinking a bunch of water if we're just going to turn around and drink some coffee. But I do want to cook all this venison first. We're tired. I'm tracking that we are tired. So I don't know if we should maybe take a nap next to the fire for an hour and then drink the coffee. Let's do that. I think we're going to do that. So we're going to rest for 1 hour. Fire should still be going when we wake up. We're just going to take a power nap. We got a warm bedroll. We're next to the fire. No. Cancel. I did not mean to rest for another hour. I meant to pick it up. Well, maybe we won't need the coffee now because now the fire is out. Ugh. And I'm really dehydrated. No, we're gonna... Oh, and I just drank a bunch of water. I am just messing up left and right. Okay. No, I think we're gonna... I'm not gonna chance it. We're going to... I can't just make a campfire on top of it? Yeah, here we go. So now we will use the book. Yeah, not the good books, just the regular book. I hate to do it, but I mean, if anything, it's lightening the weight that we're carrying, and I'm going to try to be optimistic about my goofs. I do that a lot. An extra hour of sleep couldn't hurt when you're about to scale a cliff. I mean, you know, maybe I just decided 1 hour power nap wasn't enough. I kind of wish I had thrown another log on the fire before I slept for another hour, but this gives us a chance to burn one of our heavy do-nothing books. So for the fuel, we'll throw nothing. We're going to cook a tin of coffee, and hopefully 11 minutes is enough time to get a pot of coffee going. Looks like it's going to be close. Excellent. Some hot coffee. Let's get that in our bellies. Yeah, we kind of wasted a little bit of the hydration, but Look at that. We're still winded, but we're pretty good. All right, let's do this. Oh, my. Oh, that meter is going down fast. Oh, I got a bad... Come on. You can do it. You can do it. Am I halfway? Oh, I don't think I'm going to make it. Okay, okay. Maybe I can stop at this ledge here. No, I'm not going to make it. Can I go off to the ledge? Oh, I can. Oof, okay, let's catch our breath for a second. Thank goodness. I'm glad I thought about checking out the ledge. Okay. We're just going to catch our breath for a second. And then we're going to try it again the rest of the way. We can do this. It's going to be a heck of a fall if we can't. Nope. We're not well rested enough. Okay, so here's what we're going to do. Did I not pick my bedroll up? I didn't pick my bedroll up. Oh my... No! What a mistake! What a mistake! Oh. Oh boy. Let's just wait a second. We'll catch our breath. It's not so bad. We're about halfway back. We're just gonna wait. We're gonna wait right here. Catch our breath. It's recovering. Slow and steady. Gosh, I can't believe I left the bedroll down there. It's just going to be gone. It's not worth going back to it. However, there is a second bedroll, a spare bedroll, in the cabin at Mystery Lake. I don't know how that will help me because there's only 5 hours of daylight left. And I'm going to have to rest between now and then. I don't know what I'm going to do. That is not good. I'm going to wait till this bar of energy gets up to be completely full. Oh my goodness. I'm just glad this ledge was here. Okay, let's do it. You got it. You got this. Oof, getting tired fast, though. Come on. Hand over hand. Come on. It was worth it. It was worth all this effort, though, because we got that magazine for firearms. Come on. Don't stop. No. 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 Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Please. Dig deep. You can do it. Oh. Oh, and we are flat out exhausted at this point. Completely exhausted. Okay. At this point, I don't know what we're going to do. We don't have the bedroll. I could drink another thing of coffee. But we made it up. That's actually where we're going to end the episode. Oof. Just going to take cover here. This is... Yeah, it's hard to think straight. I know. My heart's pounding. This has been The Long Dark, Episode 30. Thank you so much for joining me. Come back next time to see how we handle not having a bedroll and trying to get back with 5 hours of daylight remaining. Goodness, I don't know what I'm going to do. Anyways, I hope you had fun. I know I did. So until next time, take care.